Each time we think of construction, toilets or places of convenience are given first priority because we don't want to compromise our health standards, leading to a lot of diseases, especially the non-communicable ones. Today, we are joined by engineer Sulaiman Bulega to guide us on how a biodigester operates, its advantages over the conventional septic tanks, or how much money you need to have it installed in your home. Please don't forget to grab your copy of the Saturday Vision for our Homes and Construction Pullout, which is your number one guide in the real estate business. This is the Homes and Construction Affairs Show. My name is Hilda Kamkama. Let us go straight to Engineer Sulaiman to learn more about the biodigesters.
When you have a biodigester, you'll never need an emptier. It is a maintenance-free on-site sewage management system. A biodigester simply is a cylindrical. Some are square, but we do with the cylindricals because they are better in engineering. A biodigester is a cylindrical, 1 meter depth concrete precast tank, which specifically turns fecal matter into water. When you flush, fecal matter gets into the tank. It is immediately digested or broken down into water, and the water is soaked into the ground. So that means when you have a biodigester, you don't need an emptier. It doesn't limit space usage. You can do whatever you want on top because we install it inside the ground. It is cheaper compared to the conventional septic tanks. It doesn't keep vectors in it. Those are maggots. Mosquito is not a breeding place for mosquitoes, maggots, and whatever. It doesn't limit application. That means you can use it on a stadium, you can use it on an apartment, you can use it on a home, and most importantly, it is cheaper. Why is it cheaper? Because it can work in all soil types, whether it is a clay area, whether it is a loam area, whether it is in a red soil area. So you can install it in whatever type of terrain. Be it a rocky place, because it doesn't need a lot of depth that you'll need to dredge so low. So that is what a biodigester simply does and what it is simply made of.
Now, what do I need, or what does a person out there watching needs for starters to have a biodigester system installed in their homes?
Number one, the initial biodigester septic tank measures 1 cubic meter. A cubic meter is in equivalent of a meter by a meter, or 3.3 feet by 3.3 feet. So when you give us a job, we come, excavate, install, and it is ready to use. The initial tank is used by 1 to 40 continuous users per day. The initial tank of 1 cubic meter can serve between 1 and 40. That means if you have an apartment, if you have a home, if you have
a school
for starters, it can be used between 1 and 40 continuous users per day. When we come to the cost is between 3.2 million and 3.5 million, depending on the distance, your location, and the challenges we find at site. That is minus plumbing. That cost includes excavation, installation, and adding hardcore to the pit, and eventual covering. Then the plumbing can come afterwards.
Now, the cost you mentioned,
yes,
is it determined by the size of?
The size of the tank is determined by the number of users per day. You could be having a very big home, but with very few users. You could be having very big apartments, but with very few users. So the determinant of the size of the tank and the cost is by the number of users you anticipate to use the tank per day. The initial tank is used between 1 and 40 users per day.
Initially, we have had our normal
the conventional method.
Yes. Where we have a septic tank and all
All right.
Everything that moves with it.
Mm. Now,
when you come to a biodigester, how does it operate?
Now, the formula is simple. When you're comparing two items, we look at the advantages that one has over the other.
Exactly.
Number one, a biodigester septic tank is compact in nature. Like what we're having here is just 1 cubic meter. One cubic meter is 3 feet by 3 feet. That is what we have here.
Mm.
Yes. Now, the conventional septic tank, the use of the conventional septic tank is to store feces, store sewage. So after a period of time, you bring an emptier and it takes
empties
away.
It.
Yes. Now, a biodigester simply is a system that doesn't, that breaks that. It breaks fecal matter into water and the water is soaked into the ground. That means when you have a biodigester, you'll never need an emptier. It is a maintenance-free on-site sewage management system. You don't need an emptier all your life. Once you install it, you don't need to empty it all through. Number one, that is number one. Number two, it takes a very minimal space. Actually, it doesn't take any space at all, because once you install it, you can park, plant your grass, play on top. That is the second advantage of a biodigester when you compare it with a conventional septic tank. Number three, issues of, for those who have apartments, issues of somebody killing someone and throwing them into the tank are eliminated. There are no emergencies of a kid falling into the tank because it is sealed, airtight, and then covered with soil on top. Number four, you'll never have a mosquito around. Take a survey. Majority of septic tanks around the conventional method, when you open the lid of any of the manhole covers, what comes up are mosquitoes. So if you have a school project, you have a hotel project, if it's your home, you simply need a biodigester, simply because you won't have mosquitoes, you won't have maggots, you won't have a foul smell, because the conventional septic tank, the conventional septic tank stores fecal matter in it. So all three, you'll have a smelling pit on site. A biodigester, because it doesn't store anything, it is more like a stomach that whatever falls inside is immediately broken down into water, so you don't have any chances of something smelling around.
I need to know,
yes,
what process is that that breaks down the fecal matter to the water?
The concept, we pick the concept of manufacturing a biodigester from the stomach. Whatever falls inside the stomach is broken down and excreted either as water, that is urine, or as fecal matter.
Yeah.
So what a biodigester does, whatever falls inside,
with the help of enzymes, when
it is bacteria. Yes, to a human being, it is enzymes.
Yeah.
When you come into a biodigester, it is anaerobic bacteria. Actually, a biodigester septic tank batches anaerobic bacteria, which anaerobic bacteria helps, works within an environment of no oxygen because it's airtight. So when anaerobic bacteria gets onto the fecal matter and whatever you fall inside that is soluble in water, it is beaten up and water is discharged as the byproduct.
So the one that is beaten up, it turns to, the one that is beaten up turns to water, right?
Yes, and the water is soaked into the ground. So when you have a biodigester as a system, you install the tank and you support it with a soak pit, because the soak pit receives what has been digested, receives the byproduct, and the byproduct is water. You realize somebody, notably our people in the ghetto, where they are very tiny plots and they're usually in the wetlands. This is what we tell them. Converge those people. Instead of people having storied toilets when they're having small houses, what we tell them is simple. Let's use a common no man's land, like a road. Let's install the biodigester in the road and the soak pit, and all the homesteads around can connect. Because our tank, our initial tank, can serve between 1 and 40 users per day. So if it can serve 1 and 40 users per day, that means a small tank, the initial biodigester septic tank, can serve 5 or 6 ghetto homes.
So is a biodigester limited to a latrine or a toilet?
It has to be, the toilets have to be flushing. If you can't flush with the modern plumbing, you have to get water with you while using the toilet, because it's water that drives feces into the tank and eventually
it is beaten up.
Beaten up is the more
convenient language.
Yes, more convenient language. Immediately digested into water, and the water is soaked into the ground. Now this is what a biodigester looks like.
Is it complete?
Yes. It is not complete until it is fixed where it is supposed to be and supported with a soak pit. Otherwise, if you now give me a job and the crane can access your premises, we get there today, begin excavating, the crane simply comes, lifts the tank, takes it into the pit, add hardcore, provide a pipe, cover up, and your biodigester is ready for use.
So you, what is inside?
Because it is precast in
like,
nature.
To me what I'm seeing, it's like the whole thing is erected from down.
No. It is on surface. It is on surface, just that it's very heavy. It is made of concrete and steel. Actually, specialized concrete and steel. It is not whatever kind of concrete.
What is that specialized concrete?
It is water. It is highly waterproofed concrete, highly concentrated with chemicals, so that it can, because it works in a water environment. So you have to protect it inside and out. You have to protect it inside and out to be able to serve its purpose.
So how does the inside look like? Is it hollow?
It is concrete. It is concrete and finished. Yes.
Thank you. Now, if it is concrete, it means you're going to lift this one to one side.
Yes.
How is it going to operate? Like, serious, I'm saying now.
We have to, it is just like a stomach. Pipe. You have a mouth and where fecal matter gets out from. So we have, the fecal matter enters from here and gets out from here as water. Enters from there.
And gets out from where?
From here as water. So it has an inlet and an outlet. The outlet goes to the soak pit because it is through stones that water is soaked into the ground. And it has an inlet where fecal matter gets in.
So when I look inside, like checking from within, there's kind of like a space, right?
Yes.
Somewhere. Then the other part is all concrete. So is that how you plan, or that is how?
That is its mechanics. Yes, that is its mechanics. Mm. That is how it operates.
So you can't have any issues with the fecal matter?
Nothing like that.
Around.
Nothing like that. When installing the tank, we consider your level of plumbing. If the pipes are drawn 2 feet down, we have to follow that because the tank receives what you bring. So what determines the depth of the tank is the height of the giver. And the giver are the plumbing sewage pipes. So once they are low, we go low. Once they are high, we go high. Yes. So once we're installing it, whether you're done plumbing or not yet, we consider, because we're technical enough to see that it will rhyme with the level. If it comes at a higher level, we put at a higher level. If it comes at a low level, we put at a low level.
So in an event where someone has already constructed, has been staying in their homes, but they have realized that that expense of emptying the septic tank drained them.
What we do, we just come inspect the site and install you the alternative. And for our people who live in swampy areas, this is the only NEMA certified sewage management system. Why? Because it doesn't let disease-causing organisms into the environment. The conventional septic tank, when you get feces and pour it into the environment, you are spreading diseases. That is why people have dysentery, cholera, etc., communicable diseases. When you discharge feces from the conventional septic tank directly into the environment. Now, a biodigester septic tank treats it does treatment. Though it is manufactured and what we put inside treats. So whatever comes from it, 99% of bacteria is killed. So what do I mean by it is the only NEMA-conforming sewage management system? Whatever falls inside can't cause harm to the environment and the people. A biodigester, like I said earlier, we copy the science from God who created the stomach. The same technique that is in the stomach is the technique that we employ here. So what we do after, during the course of manufacturing the biodigester septic tank, we add inoculum. Inoculum is like a base element to help kickstart or rejuvenate the bacteria that is going to come along with the fecal matter. When you bring in fecal matter,
it is like we are rejuvenating, to
begin the process of digestion. So
from?
That the fecal matter from solids into water. So there is no chemical you need to add in over a period of time. No. The only time when the biodigester septic tank isn't functioning is a time when you are not using it. But when you begin using it all through as a must, it will keep itself working. So you don't need to. That is why we say it is an Oswald maintenance free. You don't need to maintain it. No one should sell you a chemical that, hey, put in this, it is going to work again. No. In the process of manufacturing a biotank, we fill in inoculum. Inoculum is like a base element that can begin, that is like awakens the anaerobic bacteria that poo comes with, so it begins functioning. It doesn't. Just like in your stomach, there is anaerobic bacteria which aids digestion. So from the stomach into the biotank, into the soil.
Let us look at the time, like a time frame that one may actually need to get ready to have their system all set up and ready for use.
We need a minimum of 2 to 3 days if the car can reach. We can go up to 4 days if the car cannot reach. That means the biotank has to be cast inside. On all our branches all over the country, what is required of us now is simple. When you give us a job, we come, excavate, install, and cover up.
According to the size?
According to the size.
And the occupants of the residence?
Yes. Like we say, the initial tank is used between 1 and 40 users per day. And the other speciality, we have an ongoing promotion with Water and Homes Plumbing. A biotank only is supposed to get insoluble fecal matter and toilet paper. Once you bring in your clothes or towels, they won't be digested. That is the proper use. Don't bring your mugs, rubbish into the tank. Only put in what is required. That is the fecal matter and urine. Yes. Don't bring your uvula, don't bring your pads, your pampers into the tank. Having a car doesn't mean stepping on people, rather driving on top of people. Having a car doesn't mean you have to gun brake. Having a hard metallic car doesn't mean you need a knife to scratch it to ascertain how hard it is. So is a biotank. It really does digestion. You don't need to pack in Bovera and tarpaulin to see if it really going to. So that is simply how we maintain it. If we have a school, we put in safeguards. Our system comes with safeguards that don't allow pampers
to come.
Yes, actually, if you have an apartment, if you have a home and you're challenged by blockages all through, what you do, you'll part with 200,000, we give you a safeguard. We give you a safeguard that prevents anything of the nature from getting into the tank. So whatever blockage, you'll have a blockage along the way before it gets into the tank. So the tank is secured.
Then you manage this outside.
Exactly. So use Water and Homes Plumbing. We have all the products that can maintain your biotank good, performing well all through. When the water comes off from the biotank, it has lots of nutrients. There is urine in it, so we expect urea. There is nitrogen in it, etc. That water, if you're on a split level terrain, that you have a high point where you're going to get the water, where you're going to harvest the water, yes, to draw it to the lower side, you don't need a soak pit. We just need percolation channels. What do? They move water from up downhill. So you don't need to irrigate using your national water. It cuts your water bills. Yes, you don't need a watering can. Whenever you flush, fecal matter gets into the tank. The byproduct water, discharge it, let it pass through there directly onto your flowers in the garden, your garden in your backyard garden. That is the only condition for that to happen is you have to be at a higher site, a raised terrain, so that you can discharge water. You can draw water by gravity to the lower surface.
People have just moved away from listening from NEMA. They will always invade the wetlands. And we know what happens with wetlands. Water is almost there. A few meters,
you have water.
So how have you impacted, or how can you help the people that are living in the wetlands?
There is, actually, what NEMA does, doesn't chase people from the wetlands, but it encourages a harmonious living between the person and the surrounding. So if you intend to have a beach, if you intend to have cottages by the lakeside, if you intend to have a hotel by the lakeside, if you intend to have, even on a dry land, you need a biodigester, because it treats fecal matter. It treats urine before it is discharged into the environment. That means sewage management should never be a stumbling block to your project if you have water and homes by your side, because water and homes manufactures biodigester septic tanks which are NEMA conforming, because whatever we discharge from the tanks doesn't affect the environment. Like I said earlier on, whatever moves out of the tank is used, can be used to irrigate and water plants. It can be used, reused. Actually, it is reusing, because you're not losing the water.
Yeah, reused, but the benefit now comes for the farming bit.
Exactly. And if you don't destroy the environment, that means the biotank has helped. If you discharge fecal matter directly into the surrounding, people using dugout wells and spring wells are going to have diarrhea, dysentery, cholera. But a biodigester septic tank doesn't allow that, because it's soft. It treats the sewage before it is discharged into the environment. This system has been active for 8 years. And it is still there without maintenance. Yes, some are in 8 years, some are in 10 years without maintenance. Wow. So it is a viable venture for any new homeowner, or somebody who wants to improve their homes with a better sewage management system. If you're in a swampy place, you already have a structure. If you have a swampy place, because what happens in a swampy place, before you even begin using the conventional dugout septic tank, it is already filled with water. And you'll be needing an empty all through, not because of the fill up of the fecal matter, but because of the fill up of water. You'll have water gushing from below, which is going to affect your would-be saved money onto a truck. Don't disturb your life. Just engage Water and Homes Plumbing on social media and visit our branches in Nakasero, Mengo Hill Road, Nur Emporium, Jinja, Masaka, Mbarara. Engage us. We have a solution for you. With a biodigester septic tank, you don't need an entire ever. For the municipalities around town that are congested with city dwellers, actually on the suburbs, where fecal sludge, fecal disposal is still a challenge, you have only one solution. That's a biodigester septic tank from Water and Homes Plumbing. We won't fail you. We have the solution for proper disposal of feces. When you have a biodigester, you'll never need an emptier. It is a maintenance-free on-site sewage management system. You don't need an emptier all your life. Once you install it, you don't need to empty it all through. Number one, that is number one. Number two, it takes a very minimal space.
You do not need a lot of money. You don't need a lot of space to have a biodigester installed in your place. Bye-bye to the bad odor. Bye-bye to the cost of emptying the septic tanks every now and then. A biodigester is a recommended option. Thank you for staying with us. Until next time, may God bless you.